Hello, Jonathan Alder. I'm Eli, and my day-to-day is ruined.
Why is it ruined?
I don't have my suit on, and this is APN for February 24th, 2023. 7th to 8th graders, are you ready to solve some math problems? Coming down to Ms. Phillips' room today during 7th lunch 8th intervention. You're probably not going to see this unless you watch it, I don't know, in your own personal time. 7th graders, every day during intervention, you need your homework, a physical book, as well as Chromebook.
Everything.
Every day. All 8th graders, if you need any information about the DC trip, talk to Ms. Kammeyer, see the Canvas page.
She's in room 4!
Listen to green screen, man, that's true. Happy birthday to Thomas M., Haley D., and AJ.
He's in the corner.
And then on 28th, happy birthday to Isabella W. I have one more thing to mention all 7th and 8th graders. There's a camp that will help you start learning Russian, Korean, or Chinese. You need no experience, it's also free, and it's between the days of June 4th and June 14th. This has been Eli signing off. Have a great day, J.A.
Have a great day, J.A.
Hey, good morning, staff and students. Welcome to Friday. It's Friday, February 24th, 2023. Glad you're here today. Nice job during this short week. We have 5 full days next week. Great job to our choir students last night at the choir concert. Good to see you perform. Congratulations on your hard work in that concert. Mr. Morey has a few reminders for you. Before we get to that, a reminder that we are down to, I think, our last 3 weeks of the third quarter. It's a great time for you to check your grades on Canvas if you haven't been doing that regularly, making sure that you are not the student who is trying to get everything done their last week of the quarter. Make sure you're starting to show some responsibility for yourself. Eighth graders, we've had that talk about what high school starting to look like. You put your high school schedule together. Make sure you start to show us what those high schoolers will look like for the end of your 8th grade year here at school. Mr. Moyer.
Mr. Mullaney, I have this fancy thing called a planner here. Students, we need to do a better job. We've kind of slacked off a little bit of making sure this is with you if you're in the hallway. If you are going to the bathroom, this needs to be signed. You need to sign yourself out, have the teacher sign it, and then come down to the bathroom. Okay. If you haven't noticed, we've closed the bathroom in between classes. We want to make sure that you guys are following the process, signing this out with your teacher so they know where you are and they don't ask you why you're showing up 2 minutes late after class started and all those things. So make sure we're doing a better job with this, please.
90% of you are doing a great job. Keep up that good work. 10%, we don't want you to ruin it for the rest of everybody else. So make sure everyone's following the same expectation. You know what it is. You've had it all year. We're going to hold you accountable for that. Teachers are hearing the same message too, that students are to have their planner signed before they leave, and they will not be late to your classes because they're not going to the bathroom between classes for a little while. That takes us to Funny Friday. Get ready, Mr. Moyer.
I'm not ready.
Oh, to get ready. Here they come. How do you put a baby astronaut to sleep? How do you put the baby astronaut to sleep? You rock it.
That might be the worst one.
All right, last one. How do you fix a broken tuba, Mr. Moyer? How do you fix a broken tuba? You need a tuba of glue. Tuba glue. All right, I kind of messed that delivery up. Anyhow, you're laughing or at least smiling a little bit. That will conclude today's announcement. Students and staff, we hope you have a great day. Or not. Choice is yours.
Hello, JA. I'm Tori, and this is On This Day. On this day, 1868, the House of Representatives voted 126 out of 47 to impeach President Andrew Johnson, whose lenient Reconstruction policy regarding the South after the Civil War angered radical Republicans in Congress. This happened in Washington, D.C.
Hey, J.A., I'm Henry, and I'm here this week to bring you news of the world. Recently, there was a meeting that was meant to calm people down about a toxic chemical spill in a town in our home of Ohio. The chemicals caused a very big fire. Lots of black smoke was all over the town, but crews monitoring the air were repeatedly saying that things were going to be all right. However, people didn't listen. They were still terrified of what this could cause. Thousands of fish died, and apparently some chickens as well. Some people have also said that their pets are getting sick. It's also been hard to test the water. People are saying that it isn't a good way to help fix the problem. Let's be honest, only in Ohio, folks. Anyway, that's all for me. Have a great day, JA.
Hello, JA. I'm Tori, and this is the weather.
Today, a high of 45, low of 33. Now that's a little bit cold. It's going to be mostly cloudy, so no sun really.
See too.
And a low of 38. There will be many showers, so grab your soap and your shampoo and get ready to wash. Tuesday, a high of 46 and a low of 29. It will be partly cloudy. Wednesday, a high of 49 and a low of 41. Now that's not that big of a difference. Partly cloudy, so hey.
Hello, JA. I'm Emma, and today I will be reviewing Taylor Swift's Midnights album. It was initially announced at the 2022 MTV Awards on August 28th and released on October 21st. The first version has 13 songs, and the 3 a.m. edition has 20. With sorrowful tracks such as Would've, Could've, Should've, and Bigger Than the Whole Sky, to upbeat self-love songs such as Karma and Bejeweled. The album provides great advice and subliminal warnings, such as in Dear Reader. The song opens with, "Dear reader, if it feels like a trap, then you're already in one." In Bejeweled, Taylor writes, "Putting someone first only works when you're in their top five." There are also sweet love songs, such as Sweet Nothing. To pair with those, there are breakup songs, such as High Infidelity and Midnight Rain. Overall, I would rate this album a 9 out of 10 and recommend it for any occasion.
Hey, JA, I'm Henry, and I'm here with Mrs. Conley for this week's joke of the day. So, Mrs. Conley, what do you call cheese that isn't yours?
I'm not sure, Henry. What do you call cheese that isn't yours?
Nacho cheese. I thought I might get her with that one. Anyway, that's all for me for this week. Have a great day, JA.
Hi, JA. My name's AJ, and we'll be surveying students to hear who their favorite teacher is. Hello, we're here with Maddie. We'll be asking her what her favorite teacher is. Madeline, who is your favorite teacher? All right, Miss Phillips. Hello, I'm here with Liberty. We'll be asking who her favorite teacher is. Who is your favorite teacher?
Miss Nickel.
All right, we have Miss Nickel. Hello, we're here with Tahani, and we'll be asking her what her favorite teacher is.
Miss Conkus is pretty fire, though.
Alrighty, you heard it here. Miss Conkus is her favorite teacher. Hello, I'm here with Rosie, and we'll be asking her who her favorite teacher is. Who is your favorite teacher, Rosie?
Miss Phillips.
Alright, asking him what his favorite who his favorite teacher is. Who is your favorite teacher?
Miss Klein.
Alright, Miss Klein. So we're here with Ernesto. We're going to see who his favorite teacher was. Who's your favorite teacher, mate?
Sorry to all my teachers, though. But Miss Hall, she helped.
Her of Ella, to who her favorite teacher is. Ella, who's your favorite teacher?
Bestie.
Can you elaborate?
Bestie.
Okay. This has been interviewing students to see who their favorite teacher was. Have a good JJ.